In continuation of the previous lecture about the data formats, we have discussed today the bipolar signaling. The bipolar is also called AMI RJ signaling. RJ is non-return to zero. And the bipolar shows there are two types of polarity, either low or high, or it can be one or zero. What are the advantage of bipolar or AMI RJ signaling? No DC components, there is no present of the DC components, only the variable components present in this, means there is a pulse format either 1 or 0, occupy less bandwidth within the unipolar and polar RJ schemes. It consumes less bandwidth, requires less bandwidth to represent this for type of format. So it occupies less bandwidth than the unipolar and polar RJ schemes. So there is a bandwidth advantage. Does not suffer from signal drops, suitable for transmission over AC coupled lines. It has the continuous pulses signals, either 1 or 0. There is no suddenly drops of the signalings. So it is more suitable format for power line communications. Presents signal error detection capability. Since it has the signal error detections and corrections capabilities, so it is a more suitable techniques for data codings and decodings format. Clock can be extracted by rectifying a copy of the received signals. So one more advantage of this type of format is that the clock can be easily extracted from the transmitted signals. So we can say if you use this type of techniques for sending the informations, then the clock extractions at the receiver is not easy. So what are the advantages? Synchronizations is very simple. Synchronizers become very simple to extract the information at the receiver side. What are the disadvantages? It is not transparent. It has less encryption capability, less transmission capability. Decoding of this type of format is very, very easy. So privacy is less in this type of format. HDBN signaling. HDBN is an enhancement of bipolar signaling. It overcomes the transparency problem encountered in bipolar signaling. In HDBN systems, when the number of continuous zero exceeds and they are replaced by a special code, the code is recommended by the International Telecommunication Authority of European Pulse Code Modulation System is HDB3, where n is equal to 3. In HDB3, a string of 4 consecutive zeros are replaced by either 000 would be or B00B, where B confirmed the alternative mark inversion rule, which is a violation of the alternative mark inversion rule. The reason for two different substitutions is to make consecutive violation pulses alternating polarity to avoid interruption of a DC component. The substitution is chosen according to the following rules. If the number of non-zero pulses after the last substitution is odd, the substitution of pattern will be 000 over. If the number of non-zero pulses after the last substitution is even, then substitution pattern will be 000 volt. This shows the HDBN signaling. There is no drops. It's a continuous pulse, either in 1 or in 0 format. This is a PhD of HDBN signaling. Advanced node DC component, occupy less bandwidth, RJs. Now the one more important code is the Manchester signaling. In Manchester encoding, the duration of the bit is divided into two halves. The voltage remains at one level during the first half and moves to the other level during the second half. A1 is positive in first half and negative in the second half. A0 is negative in first half and positive in the second half. Note, some books use different conventions according to their convenience. This shows the Manchester signals. If you see the diagram, now there is always a transition at the center of bit durations. If you see this, at each bit duration there is a transition either 1 to 0 or 0 to 1. This shows the pulse format of Manchester signal. This shows the power spectrum density of Manchester signaling. If you see the diagrams, the shows the peak occurs at -1 and +1, and there is a changes of pulse from 0. Normalized frequency when it is 0. The transitions at the center. Transition at the center of every bit interval is used for synchronization of the receiver. Manchester encoding is called self-synchronization at the receiving end. It can be achieved by locking on to the transition which indicate the middle of the bits. It is worth highlighting the traditional synchronization techniques used for unipolar, polar and bipolar schemes, which implies a narrow PPF to extract the clock signal, cannot be used for synchronization in Manchester encoding. This because the PhD of the Manchester encoding does not include a spectral line pulse, head symbols, even motivation does not have. Manchester signaling advantage: no DC components, does not suffer from signal drop, suitable for transfer over AC coupled lines. Easy to synchronization, which is transparent design because of the greater number of transition registers, occupies significant large bandwidth, does not have error detection capability. These characteristics make this scheme suitable for use in wide area networks. It is widely used in the local area networks such as Ethernet and token links. These are the some references book used for to understand the coding digital communication by the Grover Peter. Modernization analog communication by Gipilati, and digital analog communication system by Leo W. Koch, communication system by Simon Nicken, analog digital communication system by Martin Rutting, data communications and networking by Brose and Frozen. Thank you.